Hey, I'm on the bike path here. It's after work. It's a Friday afternoon. And I just wanted to talk to you about something that I get quite frequently. And it's, after we send a proposal out, I usually get an email back saying, hey, can you tell me, blah, 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 because I want to compare it apples to apples. Meaning, they want to take our proposal, break it down every way possible that they can so it matches every other estimate that they received, and just compare it by price. And to take somebody's proposal, any trade really, and break it down as many ways as you can and just compare three estimates to the price, that's not telling you the whole story, because trust me, that's impossible to do. So you might be able to do it when you're buying a car, possibly. But that's not taking into account the service that you're going to get from the dealerships. And the same thing with any contracting company. To just break it down and make it based off of price and claim you're doing it apples to apples is just impossible, because you're not taking into account the service that you're going to get, or lack of service you're going to get, to the warranty that you're going to get, to who's going to back that warranty, to the training that the painters receive, to the painters themselves. You have a lot of things to take into account rather than just the price alone. We can go to an estimate, a residential estimate, with two or three other companies there on site together using the same paint, the same painters, and the price should be different. It's not going to be the same. The painting industry is not standardized. We're not machines, and it's impossible to just throw us onto a site and we all do the job the same way. So that's my rant. I get that a lot. Apples to apples. I want to compare apples to apples. You can possibly do that in commercial painting, maybe, but you're still not taking into account the service and the experience different companies have. There might be companies that are better than us in certain things. Stripping surfaces or bringing an exterior down to bare wood and doing historical preservation. There's definitely companies better than us. We don't do that. Hanging sheetrock. That's not something we do. New construction. We don't really do that. But, cabinet painting, epoxy floors, interior and exterior repaints, where it's not a lot of prep and we're just coming in, doing some spot prep and then painting, that's where we're good at. And I'm not just talking about the job itself. I'm talking about communication from the office, experience, the whole nine, just being there for you, making the whole job experience a good one. Will we slip up? Sure. And trust me, every other company will too. I deal with a lot of painting companies throughout the United States, and I hear all the troubles that they have or don't have, or client issues or job issues or painter issues, or their painters didn't show up, or they can't find painters, things like that. And trust me, every painting company has them. The key is to reduce them as much as possible and try to level that experience and make the same experience from job to job for each customer. Is that always going to be 100% sure? No. Do we know that? Yes, we do. So we just want to make sure that we're hitting that as much as possible. And when something does happen, we take care of it. That's really all you can do. Guys are going to call off. Painters are not going to show up sometimes. They're going to spill some paint. They're going to drip on things. It's just the nature of the business. And we try to minimize that as much as possible. So, again, apples to apples, that's a tough thing to do. And in any industry, if I call up, three different electricians, and I'm just looking, comparing prices, it's not telling me the whole story. You can get three different prices. We'll go back to painting. If you get three different prices for the interior of your house, and you don't know what everybody's doing, or their experience level, or who's going to be out the job, or how the office is going to handle things, and you know, blah, 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 blah. There's a million different things. You can't really compare the prices. With epoxy floors, that's a good example. We just lost a project recently to a lower price, but an inferior project and product. It seemed like the customer was getting a great epoxy floor, but when we dove into it to see why we lost the project, the other company was applying a much thinner build product, meaning the product we were applying goes on thicker, it's gonna last longer. Plus, we would have had the people who do our epoxy floors on the project all the time. We don't have, you know, 100 painters out there, so we're able to manage the projects a little better. All right, so apples to apples? Not really.